Don Aslett had a dream.
I went on a trip one time with Boy Scouts, and I saw a museum in Detroit, the Edison Museum. And I thought, you know, there's cow museums, horse museums, other museums, hammer museums, hanky museums, and there's all, what about a cleaning museum?
His vision was the Clean Green World Museum. Rather than build new, he chose to renovate an existing building in Pocatello's historic warehouse district. The 50,000 square foot, five-story concrete warehouse was built in 1916.
Our mission is to teach the value of clean. So here I am an example. So, well, if I clean green, I ought to build green.
They did a lot of research before starting this program. So they attended our meetings and our easy upgrade meetings and building efficiency meetings, and then one-on-one with them going through the program.
Construction began in 2006. When completed, the 75,000 square foot project will qualify for a financial incentive from Idaho Power's Building Efficiency Program for energy efficiency in lighting, air conditioning, the building shell, and controls.
Well, Idaho Power is more enthusiastic about saving electricity than I was. I couldn't believe that. Why would a power company want to save electricity? This doesn't make sense to me. You'd want me to use a lot, but they were saying, if you do this and you do that and you do that, you can save a lot of electricity.
What's unique about this building, it's a retrofit. And so you've taken an old building with a whole lot of history, clear back to the 1920s, and be able to make this a totally efficient building.
The project is incorporating energy-efficient windows that reflect the heat but not light. And almost 90% of the building is lit by daylighting. The black tar roof was replaced with a reflective cool white acrylic coating. A concrete parking lot, rather than black asphalt, reflects the heat of the sun. Some of the other energy-efficient measures include converting an asphalt alley into a greenbelt, green roof technology as a natural insulation, a rooftop garden for insulation and filtering rainwater, a solar wall to help heat the building in the winter, and recycling up to 104,000 gallons of runoff water from the roof, sinks, showers, and other appliances.
Well, I think a lot of people will be able to come here and not only be interactive with the museum itself, they'll be able to look at the building and also want to participate in our programs and be highly energy efficient.
By using LEED measures for new construction, Don expects the project to become one of the first historic buildings to earn the highest LEED Platinum rating. With a collection of over 6,000 items, the museum will teach visitors about cleaning and showcase pre-electric vacuums and other collectibles, some dating back more than 2,000 years. The grand entrance features a 25-foot-high, three-story globe where children learn how to clean their rooms.
Right when you first come in, I've got a little form of steel. The kids stand up against it. I'm just going to push a button, and I got a great big 10-horse vacuum downstairs going, and it's going to suck the little kids out, suck all the garbage off the kids. Come to Don Aslett's Museum, I'm going to vacuum your kids. The 10-horse vacuum will use a lot of Idaho Power, but it's still going to, for a good cause.
When this project is completed, not only will it be clean, it will also be green. With videographer Lon Van Wyk, this is Anna Linskis reporting for E! News.